is a hardly prepossessing, and yet the beadle tells me you're the most accomplished of all the barbers in the city.
That is gracious of him, sir. What may I do for you today, sir? Stylish trimming of the hair. Soothing skin massage. Sit, sir. Sit.
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and pumice stone and lend me a more seductive tone, a sprinkling perhaps of French cologne. But first, sir, I think a shave.
The closest I ever came.
In a merry mood today, Mr. Todd.
Tis your delight, sir, catching fire from one man to the next.
Tis true, sir, love can still inspire the blood to pound the heart leap higher. What more
can man require
than love, sir?
More than love, sir.
What, sir?
Women.
Ah, yes, women.
Pretty women.
Sir.
My lord. And who may it be said is your intended, sir?
My ward. How pretty as a rosebud.
Pretty as a lover.
What? What was that?
Nothing. May we proceed? Pretty women. Fascinating. Sipping coffee, dancing, pretty women are a wonder. Pretty women sitting in the window or standing on the stair, something in them cheers. Pretty women,
silhouetted,
stay within you,
glancing,
stay forever,
breathing lightly.
Pretty women,
pretty women,
blowing out the
candles,
or combing out
the
mirrors,
in the garden,
letter writing,
flower picking,
weather watching,
how they make a man sing. Proof of heaven as you're living.
Pretty women,
sir,
pretty women,
yes,
pretty women,
sir, all of them
pretty women, sir.
Tom, I've seen Joanna and she said she'd leave with me tonight.
There is indeed a higher power to warn me thus in time. Joanna, elope with you. I'll make sure that neither you nor any other man shall ever set eyes on her again. As for you, Barber, it's all too clear what company you keep. Service them well and hold their custom, for you'll have none of mine.